Hi, it's Friday. Welcome to the last day of the working week. Well, it's the start of the Turtle Festival. So tomorrow during our live program, I'm sure we'll have plenty of video from the turtle parade tonight. I think there's meant to be a release of turtles. Apparently I'm releasing one. I don't know what we'll have, but you'll have to tune in tomorrow to find out. And I'm sure Steve and I will be talking a bit about local festivities in our Grumpy Old Men program. Always interesting when you get your head around a local Thai festival. Now, a reaction to stuff we were talking about yesterday, there was discussion about the labels on alcoholic beverages and how they may be weaponized to, well, I suppose, be part of the public relations about warning people about some of the dangers of drinking alcohol in excess. A poll was conducted. You may not be surprised with the results. BangkokPost.com saying that most people disagree with graphic booze labels. And the vast majority of Thais do not agree with the plan to require makers of alcoholic beverages to put a graphic label on each container to warn people of the dangers of excessive drinking. And the Department of Disease Control said that 87% out of 1,040 respondents disagreed with the plan. The result of the survey will be presented to the subcommittee responsible for the labels, which will then adopt the draft rules before presenting them to the Alcoholic Beverage Control Committee for further consideration. I think you can assume that that's not going to happen. And the Director General of the DDC tried to allay public concern about the plan, saying the draft was simply an initial reaction to academic opinions calling for graphic warnings similar to those found on cigarette packs. I'm really not sure what people were so worried about. I mean, the alcoholic beverages would still be available. They'd probably taste the same. It's just that they would have those warnings on the front, which may deter or educate some people. And the warnings would have 4 colours and 9 variations. Some of the text warnings would be things like alcoholic beverages can cause cancer, drinking alcohol can cause heart disease, drinking alcohol can cause sexual dysfunction. People would have taken notice of that one. Drinking alcohol can cause violence. Well, education is the key to this in the long run. The safe consumption of alcohol, whether it happens at the point of sale, or whether it happens in the schools, at the homes, a long-term PR campaign on TV, I suppose that we'll just have to see. But I think in the short term, those labels, those warning labels on alcoholic beverages, probably not going to happen. Another story from the BangkokPost.com, baht projected to weaken following poor economic figures. So those people bringing US dollars into the country, might be good news for you. And despite recent appreciation, the baht remains under pressure to weaken and is expected to move in a range of 36 to 36.5 baht to the US dollar this month. And after falling below 36 baht to the greenback on Wednesday this week, the Thai currency was quoted at nearly 36 baht to the dollar yesterday as the dollar eased overnight, with US economic growth slightly lower than originally forecast at 3.3% in the fourth quarter of 2023. And far from stumbling, the US economy grew 2.5% in 2023, topping a 1.9% uptick in 2022. And Patrick Pouliot, the executive vice president and head of the financial markets function at Siam Commercial Bank, said in the short term, the baht is tending to depreciate as the dollar gains in line with treasury yields, which are expected to remain high in the near term. And then BOFA Global Research said the baht is exposed to rising freight costs, as this could add to import bills. And BOFA projects the currency to trade at 36 baht to the greenback by the end of the first quarter. So that's just the US dollar to the Thai baht. How's your currency doing against the Thai baht? Some more economic data out again from the Bangkok Post. Auto slowdown dents January index, and the manufacturing production index decreased by nearly 3% year on year to 99.2 points in January as the country struggled with many economic problems. And further down there, car manufacturing decreased by nearly 10% year on year as the number of seized cars rose to 250,000 last year. That's around 20,000 units a month. in the OIE Director General said the situation caused banks to be more cautious in granting car loans, which affected domestic car sales. And in January, petroleum production decreased by 6.4% year-on-year as some oil refineries closed for maintenance, while the manufacturing of electronic parts and circuit boards dropped by 17.7% year-on-year. And coming up a little bit later, we'll be talking about a workshop being put together by the Tourism Authority of Thailand, and I'll be after your input. And thanks to John Armstrong, who arrived at the Chip Fair Lele Cafe when I was having breakfast this morning. Now, he didn't bring cherry ripes. Well, the conversation almost finished there. But he did bring me some dark lint chocolate and also some black cherry jam. And he said maybe I could put them together and get a sort of an approximation. I'll certainly be trying those, probably separately. And he also got some Wiley Wallaby licorice. I'll enjoy all that, not all at the same time, but thank you very much, John, for your ongoing support of the program. I think John was our first guest at the Bonneville Beach House when we opened some, I don't know what, 4 or 5 months ago. But thank you very much. Now, moving into some other stories, and the Deputy Prime Minister, Anutin, that's Anutin Charvitakun, used to be the Public Health Minister, highlights progress of drinking tap water policy at Provincial Waterworks Authority anniversary ceremony. And it happened on February the 28th, and the Deputy PM, Anutin, and relevant agencies participated in the awards and honours for the 45th anniversary of the Provincial Waterworks. Then blah, 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 what the awards were all about. And then Anutin mentioned the progress of the drinking tap water policy, emphasising its importance for the Thai people at all levels. He mentioned that the necessary steps were being taken, committees were in place, and the budget was being reviewed. Now, about drinking water, tap water in Thailand, I mean, all of us for just about forever have been told, make sure you don't drink out of the taps, make sure you drink water out of plastic bottles, which I'm sure we've all been doing. Now, having lived in Phuket for 12 years, now living up here on Turtle Beach in Phanga, I have to say that universally, the water coming out of the taps has been clear. There's no odour to it. And I suspect it's probably perfectly potable. I'm not going to be the one to test that, but I'm pretty sure the water is okay. But there's still the feeling that, no, you shouldn't be drinking tap water in Thailand. So it looks like there is a policy to try and make it universal across the country. And he said there should be no obstacles, and once the budget is approved, actions can be taken nationwide simultaneously. After the approval, he would issue an order to all relevant sectors to accelerate the progress of the drinking tap water policy. The goal is for tap water to be drinkable all across Thailand, notes TPN Media. So another promise, and probably fairly expensive, to lay new pipe right around the country. I imagine it's going to be the ubiquitous blue PVC pipe. But yeah, potable water in Thailand. What's your feeling? Do you think the water that you see coming out of the taps in Thailand is already potable? Would you dare to drink it? I would, but you go first. Another story reported by the PattayaNews.com. Bolt driver shot dead, another injured in Pattaya shooting. And a shooting incident in Pattaya resulted in the death of a Bolt driver. This happened on February the 28th. And it happened in Nong Pru in Bang Lamung, and the victim was a 30-year-old driver, Chatchai Pantong. And he was a driver for the ride-sharing application Bolt. And another individual, a 39-year-old who's a Muay Thai trainer, was found suffering from a skull fracture after being struck by the butt of a gun by the suspect. He received initial medical attention before being rushed to hospital. A 9mm bullet casing was collected as evidence. And just summarising the paragraph above, another resident reported witnessing an altercation between several young individuals outside the house before hearing two gunshots. He then observed Mr. Chatchai fleeing towards the back of the house before collapsing. So the attack on the Bolt driver seemingly disconnected from any other grievances the traditional taxis have against the ride-hailing apps. It just seems to be a local suburban dispute. With thanks to our sponsor, Five Star Marine at fivestarmarinephuket.com. The best way to head out onto Phuket Bay when you're next in the south of Thailand, specifically around Phuket. Make sure you give Sean and his team a call before you book with anybody else. They come highly recommended from me. Now, our Prime Minister, Setar Tawisin, has been out and about again. Setar tells the TAT, that's the Tourism Authority of Thailand, to brainstorm on ways to ignite Thailand, other than just making up numbers. And the Tourism and Sports Ministry and the TAT are organising a workshop for tourism agencies to explore measures that will make Thailand a global tourism hub as part of the government's Ignite Thailand initiative. And Setar Tawisin unveiled the initiative earlier this month, laying out ambitious plans for making the country a hub for tourism, medical treatment, food, aviation, logistics, electrical vehicles, digital economy and finance, and he's going to do all that by 2030. And the TAT Governor Tapani said on Wednesday that the three-day workshop will be held between March the 12th and the 14th. Check my diary and see if I'm available. And central and provincial tourism agencies, as well as entrepreneurs in the tourism industry, will be invited to join the workshop to provide their input and suggestions. Now, given that there's a lot of foreign tourists coming into Thailand, apart from the tourists circulating inside domestically, I wonder how many foreigners they're going to invite onto this workshop. Expected participants include the Department of Tourism, Thailand Privilege Card, that's the Thailand elite, the Designated Areas for Sustainable Tourism Administration, the Thailand Convention and Exhibition Bureau, the Civil Aviation Authority of Thailand, Airports of Thailand, and airline operators. Well, except for the airline operators, I don't see a foreigner in sight. And the workshop will cover four main aspects of a tourism promotion strategy: promotion of second-tier provinces. There's a big push to try and get people to go to places other than Bangkok, Pattaya, Phuket, Chiang Mai. Pushing Thailand to be an entertainment complex by organising world-class festivals, events and concerts through joint investment with private partners. And number three, pushing for a one visa policy in the ASEAN region, similar to the Schengen visa scheme in the EU. And number four, revising tourism regulations with a focus on minimising obstacles to travelling and facilitating the organisation of world-class events. Well, a lot seems to be happening in the way of tourism, easing up visa regulations for some countries. It seems the expats living here full-time are the ones, well, being ignored at the moment. I'm feeling unwanted. And the TAT will need cooperation from all related parties, both public and private, in making Thailand a tourism hub by 2030. This is according to Tapani from the TAT. Everyone must be a champion of this policy, including all provincial governors, a local administration organisation, the private sector and community members who will eventually benefit from increasing tourism income. I really think they'd get some interesting perspectives and, well, some different outlooks if they had a few foreigners, maybe some people who come to Thailand as tourists often, at this workshop. But I suspect that's just not going to happen. One particular group of foreigners who have been promoting Thailand very well, and we go to nationthailand.com, livestream from Phuket draws 15 million Chinese viewers, generates 150 million Thai baht, 15 million live stream viewers. That's only 14,990,000 more than I get. And these are the two ladies who were doing the live stream, obviously in concert with the TAT and the Tourism Ministry, and the live streaming session in Phuket on Wednesday to sell Thailand's tourism products and services to the Chinese drew over 15 million viewers, generated more than 150 million baht in revenue. And the event was called Super World Trip Boss Live, and it was conducted by Trip.com Group, a multinational travel service conglomerate headquartered in Shanghai. And the previous live streaming event was held at a hotel in Bangkok on January the 31st, and that drew 20 million online viewers and generated more than 220 million baht in revenue. And with total sales of 370 million baht for both events, the agency said that it expected the project to boost demand for Thai tourism to the Chinese market. The TAT aims to attract as many as 8 million Chinese tourists to Thailand this year, more than double the 3.5 million last year, but still far below the almost 11 million seen in 2019, the year before the pandemic struck. 15 million live stream viewers. I'm not even slightly jealous. But good luck to those people for using social media and the power reaching out to the huge Chinese market. And let's hope that they can attract a few more tourists. And with that, I thank you very much for watching today. Please subscribe to the channel. Have a fantastic Friday. I'll be online tomorrow morning between 9 and 10 a.m. I might even have a few Wiley Wallaby licorice left. Maybe not. Have a look at my teeth. If they're black, they're all gone. But we'll see you tomorrow. Then, of course, Sunday with Grumpy Old Men. Good luck to everybody in the parade tonight, especially you, Steve, and your wonderful turtle float. We'll be out there watching, and we'll see everybody tomorrow, sometime over the weekend. Otherwise, maybe next Monday.